पंजाबी चिकन करी। हाय आई एम अनुपा एंड वेलकम टू संजीव कपूर खजाना। लेट्स मेक अ पंजाबी चिकन करी। This Punjabi chicken curry is slightly different from the regular chicken curry. Why? We will see. So to make this curry, what do you need? We need chopped onions, chopped tomatoes, chicken, ginger paste, bay leaf, chopped coriander leaves, pure ghee, yogurt, black peppercorns, black cardamom, cloves, cinnamon, green cardamom, garlic paste, garam masala powder, turmeric powder, coriander powder, red chili powder, and salt. So once you have all these spices and all the other things prepared, we'll quickly make the chicken curry. So to make this chicken curry, I have a big pan in which I'll first start off with some pure ghee. Now with this chicken curry, like you see, everything is in chopped form. There isn't anything which is grated or pureed. It's just a very robust chicken curry. Chicken is also done. This is not... We've just washed chicken under running water and we've kept it. Onions are chopped, tomato is chopped. All that will give it the gravy form is the yogurt. So, before we begin, once the pure ghee is well heated, we will infuse in all the whole spices. So, here I have few of them. We'll just add in one by one. So, to begin with, we'll add in a bay leaf. We'll add in some green cardamom, black cardamom, some cloves, some black peppercorns, cinnamon. So after you have added all the spices, we'll add in the onion. And this onion has to brown. Now this is where the actual time would take. So what you should do is, I'll tell you, you shouldn't keep anything ready like this. First thing that you should do is chop onions and put a pan with ghee to heat. So by the time the pan is well heated, you have chopped the onion, and you add in the whole spices and then you add the chopped onion into the pan and let this brown. In the meanwhile, you can do all the other preparations like chopping your tomatoes, whisking your yogurt, chopping the fresh coriander. So you don't waste time. Onion, yes, it does take time to brown because first it will get rid of the moisture and then it will start browning. So that time is definitely there and you can't really do much about it. But if you plan your cooking well, then it's definitely not very time consuming. Okay, so here you see the onion has almost got golden in color. We'll now add in all the powder spices. We'll start off with turmeric powder, red chili powder. We'll add some coriander powder. And after we've added all the powders, first thing that we will do is mix this well. Okay, the masalas don't take very long to saute, but now we have to add in the ginger garlic paste. This is ginger and garlic. After you have done this, mix this well. Okay, so now we have sauteed this. Now we need to add in the tomatoes. The tomatoes that we are using are also chopped. So we'll add in tomatoes to this. And to this, after adding tomatoes, we'll add in some salt. Why? Because when you add salt to tomatoes, it leaves moisture faster. So that way the tomatoes get cooked faster. And we have to cook this till the tomatoes go pulpy. So for that, you can just increase the heat. This can be done on high heat since there's a lot of moisture in this pan right now. So just keep on sauteing this. So the tomatoes have gone soft. Now we'll add in the chicken pieces. And after you add in the chicken, mix this well. Now after you add this and you've added everything, keep on sauteing this till the chicken is well seared in the masala. Before we add in any other thing, in this case, to give it the kind of gravy consistency, we are going to add yogurt. You could also add plain water. But since this is a Punjabi chicken curry, yogurt is quite essential. And yogurt is something that will give it its gravy and at the same time slight tartness. So now we have flipped the chicken pieces and we are cooking the other side as well. So after we have sauteed the chicken well in the masala, it's time to add in yogurt. When yogurt comes in contact with heat, it splits. In this case, we won't add any binding agent because we want the yogurt to split and give it a good gravy. So that is how it is. We'll add in some fresh coriander also at this stage. Salt we have already added while we added the tomatoes. So right now we won't add any salt. If salt is needed, then that we will adjust it later. Oh wow, this is looking just perfect. So after this we will cover this and we will let this cook till the chicken goes tender. This will take anywhere around 15 minutes. After 15 minutes we'll check if the chicken is just done. The leg pieces is where it takes a little longer to cook. So whenever you check if a chicken is well cooked or no, always check the leg piece. So it's been about 15 minutes, so let's check if the chicken is done. Yes, the leg bone, if you can see, it has actually left the meat. So we'll switch off the heat, mix this well, and now let's add in some garam masala powder. And we'll mix this well in a serving bowl. Here you go, Punjabi chicken curry is ready. Serve this piping hot with steamed rice or garam garam roti. And make this recipe just the way I have made it and you'll be very happy.